How's it going? If you want to get to the ratio video, just click here. I'm probably gonna leave a timestamp, or just go to that timestamp so you can get to what this main video probably you clicked for. But this is just a vlog too, and I wanna kind of get, you know, to talk a little bit about what happened today. So I did that video, of course, you know, that's something that I did, just OBS recording and stuff like that. I also had something to eat. Of course, that's always good. And in the middle of that, eating is the main video for today. Which camera should I get? Should I get a kind of like a decent budget camera, mirrorless, you know, like, or should I get a DSLR? I don't know, I'm still deciding. I had a conversation with Melissa and we were thinking like, what do we do? Budget, you know, kind of like times are uncertain. Yes, you know, what should I do? I don't know. Comment down below. I really want to hear your suggestions. I've been thinking, I watch a lot of videos, like, you know, from Mari and Potato Jet, and also from Peter McKinnon. And, you know, I've been looking like, well, you know, they have a lot of following and they have a great camera systems. I mean, they're awesome. Their videos are great. And I'm thinking like, do I want that or I just want to step up? So how do you select a camera for YouTube? Like, you know, I guess my guidelines right now is not overspend. I don't want to overspend. So that's why I'm kind of like hesitant of doing like an EOS R. You know, the EOS R is great. It's an amazing camera, but I'm kind of thinking like, do I have the money to actually, you know, just do that? Or is a Canon M50 enough? You know, like, well, that will improve definitely over my Pixel 4, but you know, I'm thinking, so I don't know if you guys YouTube, you know, if any of you does, make sure to like hit, you know, just comment down below. Tell me like, hey, this is a suggestion. This is what I did. This is what the budget I started. And I know there's other things like lights, you know, and like microphones and things of that nature. I'm more aware of those. It's not just the camera. I get that. And the lens, of course, the ND filters. There's a lot of stuff that goes into it. But I'm kind of figuring it out. Like, you know, I don't know which one is actually better. Is better to just get like one big purchase, right? Get the EOS R or the R5, you know, that just came out yesterday. Super expensive, then get another expensive lens, right? But that'll be it, probably for, I don't know, 5 years or 6 years, right? Or do I get like a Canon M50, an M6 Mark II, a Sony A6000 and 6100 maybe? Like, you know, something like budget range, has great stuff. Good accessories, you know, stuff like that. A6400, I guess, you know. I don't know, Mike. I mean, I'm thinking out loud right now and just kind of like figuring it out by myself. I think I'm going to go with like a lower budget, kind of like maybe an EOS RP, you know, or maybe an M6 Mark II. I don't know, you know, I want to travel. I want to showcase what I'm doing. That's what I'm starting to vlog. But I'm not sure, you know. Drop a comment below. Help me out. I'm really, you know, kind of like struggling here because I'm not sure what I want. Do I want something that's really, really good and I will never, you know, have to upgrade ever again? Or do I want to upgrade incrementally? Just do one upgrade and then do that. That's really, really, really good, you know? That's what I did with the podcast. And that's maybe what I'm inclined to. I remember when I first started the podcast, I had a Yeti, you know, which I will never recommend anyone getting. You know, if you have it, I'm sorry. You know, that's just my opinion. Condenser mics are not good for interviews, especially with all the noise that you can get, you know, from the person. But then I upgraded for like, you know, like an SM58. Yes, an SM58 and then an SM7B. So like, you know, I went incrementally and getting that, you know, better audio and kind of fine tuning my skills to the point that I think I have a good sounding podcast. But video is different, you know. I mean, camera quality is very important, so I'm kind of struggling here. Help me out, you know, what are your suggestions? If you're a YouTuber, if you have a channel, if you produce a couple videos, maybe that's your field of work. Help me out, you know, I'm trying to figure it out. I'm trying to make a decision probably by the end of the month or by the end of next month. I'm still gonna vlog on the Pixel at least for another month, but I like to have a kind of like a solid decision. So the options are super budget, you know, just go for it, you know, max it out, or really do, you know, very kind of like minimal budget kind of camera. So other things I did just worked out, ate, had that conversation, and yeah, so enjoy the video for the block ratio 18, no, sorry, block ratio installing. So, hey, there it is.
Hey everyone, welcome back. So today we're going to be kind of checking out Ratio. So after you go through your Gmail and you get to this email that they're going to send you, it says your personal Ratio invitation. You're going to go to the download page. After you click the download page, you're going to get two versions. It's either going to be the block for OS X or block desk for Windows. And of course, also the community tab. I'm going to show you that. I'm signed in into the community tab. Once you get on, you'll be able to kind of get bugs reported or, you know, anything else. We're going to keep that file right there. Keep anywhere, of course, because that's the file that you need once you download it. I have Windows, so I downloaded Windows. After that, you're definitely just going to click Block Desk right here, and it's going to take you through, you know, just setting it up. Of course, you got to get through Run Anyway. And right there, it's going to be installing Block Desk, the latest version. I'm just doing it again for you guys, even though I had already connected, but that's just going to wait. You're going to wait, you know, kind of like wait through it. And then boom, we have Block Desk and it's going to open automatically. Of course, everything is synced because I already had synced it before, and you need your phone, you need, you know, a USB. We're going to disconnect it for the meantime. After this, you're going to go to Ratio and you're going to click. It's going to say right there what's the newest kind of like thing that's going on. In this case, is it was released yesterday. You're going to click next, enable developer options. I already enabled on my phone, so we're just going to continue. After that, you turn on USB debugging, and then you're going to connect your phone. Once you connect your phone, you're going to get a pop-up on the phone, and it's going to say allow. So I'm going to allow right there. And then it's going to ask for the verification code. I'm going to paste my verification code. It's only one per person, so even if you share it, it doesn't work for other people. So you got kind of have to wait, and it's okay. You know, be patient. It's going. Your invite is going to get there. After that, you hit confirm, and then it's going to write a lot of permissions, like, you know, SMS and SMS, things like that. It's going to confirm. It's going to install Ratio right there. It's going to install the icons, the lines APK, and then it's going to install the Ratio files for you guys, and then that's it. You have Ratio on your phone, and after that you can check out my other video how it looks. But I want to go through a couple other things, like Z18 OS. If you have a Z18, of course this will be the way that you will flash your device. If you have notes, you want to put some notes in your kind of phone right there, you can write them up. Note 21, April 21, and then it'll show up on my phone, but of course I don't want one, so it's okay. Back to the desk, then you go to the dashboard. These are the things that I have been using. As you see, my most used apps right there. Today I've used my phone 39 minutes. Usually I use it for 2 hours and 46 minutes. That's a lot. Monthly use, it tells me the biggest days, you know, and everything that has been going on. Files, you know, you can get all of the stuff right there. You can get photos right there, WhatsApp images, camera, devices. That's my Pixel 4. And then you can sync, which will sync your photos, your videos. If you want the program to start, kind of like on startup, you can do that as well. Then you have the settings, which is, or, you know, you can customize the phone whichever way you want. This is just kind of like one way of looking at it. But there is a lot of things that you can do and customize it from here. Especially when you first get it, you get a bunch of tools and a bunch of things like that that, you know, is not organized. So you definitely want to organize, and I have it organized at this point. And that's pretty much it, you know, about, edit, you know, things like that. That's the newest version, 0.60. Of course, you also want to check your paths, you know, and it'll be installed on AppData roaming. So that's where, you know, you get your blocked desk, you know, and this is helpful if you want to check, you know, something for the APK, or, you know, if you want to check something that you get for, you know, all of your other programs. So, you know, make sure that you know where you're getting it. This is the block flash that you need in order to flash it. If not, it wouldn't work. So I hope you enjoyed the video, and of course, make sure to, you know, just take a look at other videos that I have produced, and thanks for watching to the vlog and for the video today. So hope you have a great day, and I'll see you on the next one.